previous session, children, we studied the concept of resistivity, that is under the factors on which the resistance of a conductor depends on. I set you in page 101 in your textbook 101. There is table 12.2 which clearly explains the resistivity of the various materials. I am repeating, children. As and when you go through the video, please read the related topic in the textbook. That will help you a lot. So till now, till up to 9th, what you are doing is depending on the notes and reading the lesson only once for your glancing or something. But in the public exam, no questions from the exercise will be asked. It was completely from the textbook. From anywhere in the middle of the textbook, they can pick the questions. So read textbook. Please follow it. Read textbook from the beginning. Make it a habit. Now, here in your textbook, children, so they have defined it as rho is a constant of proportionality and it is called electrical resistivity of the material of a conductor. SI unit of resistivity is ohm meter. It is a characteristic property of the material. The metals and alloys have low resistivity in the range of 10⁻⁸ to 10⁻⁶ ohm meter. They are good conductors of electricity. Insulators like rubbers and glass have a range 10⁻⁰ to 10⁻⁷ ohm meter. Both the resistance and resistivity of a material vary with temperature. Please underline this. See, both the resistance and the resistivity of a material depends on the, it vary with the temperature. So you can understand how by going through this table. See, table reveals that the resistivity of an alloy is generally higher than of its constituent metals. Alloys do not oxidize readily at high temperature. So oxidize means when it comes in contact with the air, it will catch fire. That is oxidizing. But alloys do not oxidize means immediately when it comes in contact with the air, it doesn't catch fire at high temperatures also. For this reason, they are commonly used in electrical heating devices like electric iron, toasters, etc. Tungsten is used almost exclusively for filaments of electric bulb, whereas copper and aluminium are generally used for the electrical transmission lines. So what you see, usually the conducting wires are, it will be inside the insulation, that is the colors of the wires you see, it will be of different colors. If you cut open the plastic insulation part, you will see they are mainly the copper or the aluminium wires. In case of electric bulbs, tungsten is used, you all know it. And alloys are used in heating devices, maybe like iron box or toasters, etc. Why? Because they do not oxidize easily, means they do not catch fire when they come in contact with the air. That is very important. Next, you have few numericals, example 12.3 to 12.6. which I will be solving on the board. It is mainly on the problems of, that is on Ohm's law, and this resistivity R is equal to rho into L by A formula. So let us see how to solve. It is very easy problem, children. Only thing is you should know to manipulate the formulas and don't forget to write the units. Now let us solve all the. So children, first we should solve example 12.3 in your page number 102 of your textbook. Question is, how much current will an electric bulb draw from a 220 volt source if the resistance of the bulb filament is 1200 ohms? Is the first part A. In the second part, how much current will an electric heater coil draw from a 220 volt source if the resistance of the heater coil is 100 ohms? So let us take the first part, that is A. Our first step is, let us write the given data. Question is, how much current will an electric bulb draw? How much current, if they are asking, means we don't know current I. So I is equal to question mark. From an electric bulb, with that will an electric bulb draw from a 220 volt source, means V is equal to 220 volt source if the resistance of the filament of the bulb is 1200 ohms, means 1200 ohms. This is how you should write the given data, children. Learn it everywhere V is equal to 200 ohm, R is equal to 1200 ohms. Along with this only you should write, because we will not be valuing your papers. It is outsiders, so they go through each and everything here. So write the given data in a proper way. I we don't know, V we know, R we know. So V, I and R means these three physical quantities relate to what? Obviously Ohm's law. What is Ohm's law? V is equal to I into R. Here V is equal to I into R. We don't know what is I. I taught you not to manipulate the formula. I don't know I. So what is I? V is there. And between I and R multiplication is there. If I send it to other side, you will divide. That is equal to I. So I is V by R. I will rewrite the formula for my convenience. Why? Because we always have habit of keeping the unknown quantity on the left hand side. So I is equal to V by R. I will write. Next step is substitution. How much is V? 220 volts divided by R is 1200 ohms. See, one zero gets cancelled with the other zero. So I am left with 22 divided by 120. Shall we do with two table? 2 ones are 2 ones are 2 60s are. You got 11 divided by 60. So here let us go with actual division. 0.063 is 18. It is more than that. 6 twos are only 1 plus 60. 0, 11 minus 6. How much? 4. So next point is there. Take 0. 6 6 is 36. 6 7 is 42. It is. So we have to go with 6. 60 into 6 is 320. I don't want, what is the difference? I got 0.16. I is equal to 0.16 ampere. Final answer, I is 0.16 ampere. Always write the final answer in the box with unit like this. This is how you will solve. Very simple it is. Ohm's law we used. Unknown quantity, I we find it out. Similarly, you have part B. How much current will an electric heater coil draw from a 220 volt source? Again, it is 220 volts. If the resistance of the heater coil is 100 ohms is given. So here also I means up to here we can retain the same steps. Now let me substitute. V is 220. R is 100. 0, 0 gets cancelled. I am left with 22 divided by 10. 2 5s are 10. 2 11s are 22. 11 divided by 5. So 5 2s are 10 means 1 remaining 0.0. 5 2s are 10. I got I to be 2.2. That is I is equal to 2.2 ampere is the current. Previously we got I is equal to 0.16 ampere. This is solution to A. This is solution to B, children. We got I to be equal to 2.2 ampere. Now they have given one sentence. Note the difference of current drawn by an electric bulb and electric heater from a heater from same 220 volt source. If you observe, voltage V was same for both the electric heater and electric bulb. It was 220 volt, but resistance for the heater, for the filament bulb, was 1200 ohms, whereas for electric heater is 100 ohms. So resistance is only varying, but voltage is kept constant. 0.16 and 2.2 ampere. There is so much variation.